Let us discuss about the polarization of dielectrics and electric field. To understand the polarization of dielectrics, let's have a look on the situation in which we are given with a dielectric slab. It is a polar dielectric slab in which there are several dipoles, molecular dipoles, which are randomly distributed in the whole volume of the dielectric slab. Now, let's see what will happen when an external electric field is applied onto it. Due to this electric field, on each dipole, the positive centers will experience a force in the direction of electric field and negative centers will experience a force opposite to the direction of electric field. And the couple produced on each dipole will rotate the dipole and all will get aligned in the direction of electric field, as you can see in the situation. Once the dipoles get aligned, here in this situation you can see, on the left surface of dielectric slab, there are some negative centers, on the right surface there are some positive centers. In the volume, we can ignore all the positive and negative centers because their overall electric field exists only within the volume of this slab. But those electric line of forces which are coming from the external region or external electric field, you can see some of these lines will terminate onto these dipoles or negative centers of the dipoles, and same number of lines will originate on the right surface of the dielectric slab. And here, due to this, you can see the overall flux density in the region between the dielectric slab is less compared to the flux density in the outside region. So here we can write that electric field external, if it is equals to E, then electric field inside the dielectric slab we can write as equals to external field minus the electric field due to polarization of this dielectric slab. This whole phenomena we call dielectric polarization, and the charges which are induced on the surfaces of the dielectric, which are say plus sigma I and minus sigma I, these will produce an opposite electric field EP, and due to this the net electric field inside is decreased. And this net electric field is accounted by a constant parameter related to the dielectric we call dielectric constant. Say if its dielectric constant is equals to epsilon r, this inside electric field we can write as E by epsilon r. As epsilon r is always greater than 1, the magnitude of inside electric field is always less. So indirectly we can say that this dielectric constant epsilon r gives us a mathematical measurement of the polarization electric field of the dielectric slab. Let's discuss this in detail in the coming sections. We'll also calculate the amount of induced charges developed on the surface of dielectric, which are actually called bound charges.